iGEM stands for the International Genetically Engineered Machine Competition. It's a global synthetic biology competition that brings together teams from all around the world to compete in essentially engineering organisms to have new functions. Our project this year was to use a co-culture system of bacteria and yeast to synthesize plant-derived compounds more efficiently. A lot of the compounds like medicinal or used in cosmetics, all of these are extracted from plants, and we want to find a way that's more sustainable and reliable.
So we created a 3D printer, which prints hydrogels, which has our E. coli and yeast that has engineered pathways within it so that it can function to make the enzymes that produce our end product.
It's essentially split up into fall and spring semester. Spring is like brainstorming phase, summer is like hardcore lab work, and then fall is like wrapping up the project, working on the presentation aspects.
Everything is done by undergrads, but we're still under the guidance of professors and TAs, but we get the freedom to choose what we want to do and how we want to do it in a way that you would never get in a professor's lab.
It's on us to do that literature research or find the experts in the field that can answer those questions. It's really all up to us to get that fundraising and all the steps in between for really writing a research paper overall, technically.
Our team this year was a bit smaller. We had 10 members compared to usually the U of R teams have like around 12. So what we did was some of us doubled up on roles. My specific roles on the project were hardware and video leads. Essentially for me, that entailed scripting, filming, editing, and animating.
I was lab and safety manager. So I was also responsible for HPLC. So like detection of the small molecules we're trying to synthesize.
My specific role in the project was to be the software manager, and I was also co-wiki manager, which would mean that I created the website. I also did a lot of the hardware tasks, and I was on the wet lab team as well.
Projects like these, they usually take like years, like for PhD students, grad students to develop. And the fact that we're undergrads doing this, and we were given from February to November, I think that's a pretty big undertaking. A typical bioprinter will cost over $10,000 easily. For us, we engineered one under $500. And what we want to do is have a 3D bioprinter that's accessible for labs who want to do this proof of concept with whichever molecules they choose.
You could change the genes you put into bacteria, change the genes you put into yeast, and so you could use it to produce virtually any plant-based chemical you want. And so the fact that we have our printer available on our wiki and it's all open source, all of the CAS designs are out there. We have a guide on how to build it, a guide on how to connect it to the motherboard and how to upload the new firmware. So virtually anyone could build our printer and use it. The Grand Jamboree was a great experience. So it was held in Paris this year. It's just a huge conference type of thing with about 400 teams. It was just very fun to get to know all these different people from all over the world.
They really go full out with the whole conference. They had like little villages for each track. So we're the biomanufacturing village. So they would have like a little section with like a stage, which is where we did our informal plaza presentation. Then we had like little booths for each team to present at.
We put in a lot of work and I think it definitely paid off. We were nominated for best hardware. So that's top 5 out of the 400 teams. We also got nominated for Best Biomanufacturing, and we got a gold medal. This project really taught me a lot of things that I wouldn't learn in the classroom, or I learned in the classroom as like a concept, but never really applied.
iGEM didn't necessarily change my career trajectory, but it definitely changed me as a person. I feel like a lot of the growth that you do throughout college is not necessarily defined by like academics, but character growth. A lot of the things that I learned and gained from this were not necessarily tangible things, but how to communicate with people, how to delegate, how to throw yourself into things that you had no idea how to do. Essentially how to start from ground zero and work your way up to like being an expert at what you do.
We can continue our project on our own. There's a lot of iGEM resources on how to take this project outside of just a classroom setting and actually really develop it, so we'll just see how the future takes us.